going to continue with factoring using the box method. That was in the previous video I did. This is just an alternative way to factor. So we're going to draw a box here. And we know the answer to the problem. I want to end up with, if I multiply two binomials, 4x squared plus 5x minus 6. So the 4x squared must have been here, the negative 6 must have been here, and the question of the day is, what two terms would go in here so that it adds up to plus 5x? So we know that the variable part is x. Well, I need to make sure that the product of those two coefficients is the same as the product of the first and last term here. So I want the product to be negative 24, and the sum of the coefficients has to be positive 5. So we list those as usual. Numbers that multiply out to be 24. 1 and 24, 2 times 12, 3 times 8, and 4 times 6. Since the sum is positive, the bigger number must be positive. And since the product is negative, the other number must be the opposite sign, so it's negative. Okay, which gives us the correct combination that adds up to positive 5? Negative 3 and 8. So that's what we want to put in here. It doesn't matter where we put the negative 3, where we put the 8. So let's just put the 8 here and the negative 3 there. You could switch it and you'll get exactly the same answer. Okay, so now let's start with the first column. Pull out the greatest common factor to the top. That's going to be x. And now we do the side. X times what will give me 4x squared? That'll be 4x. And then 4x times what up here will give me 8x? That's going to be plus 2. And then 2 times what will give me negative 6? Negative 3. So that means our factorization must be x plus 2 times 4x minus 3. And you check by, of course, doing the FOIL method or the box method and make sure you really get 4x squared plus 5x minus 6. Yes, this takes a little bit of room, but you got the right factors. That's what really matters. Can you get the right factorization? You could do it by trial factors, remember. You could do the shortcut method. You could do factoring by grouping. You could use the box method. I know in a couple other ways. But basically, we want to make sure we get the correct factors, two binomials that multiply out to be 4x squared plus 5x minus 6. Okay, here's another problem. Put it on pause and see if you could figure it out. So you're going to try to factor 6x squared minus 13x plus 6. I've drawn the box for you to get started. And we know the answer after you add all four terms in the box should be 6x squared minus 13x plus 6. All right, so let's go for it. 6x squared came from this box, so that must have been 6x squared. And plus 6 came from this box, so that had to be plus 6. So we need to figure out what goes in these two boxes, has to add up to negative 13x, so the variable part's x. So we want the product to be the 6 times 6. Now you could look in here, or first and last term here. Product is 36, sum is negative 13. Okay, numbers that have a product of 36. 1 and 36, 2 and 18, 3 and 12, 4 and 9, 6 and 6. Now, since the sum is negative, the bigger number must be negative. Since the product is positive, the two numbers must have the same sign. So we're looking for the combination of two numbers that adds up to negative 13, and there they are. So we need to put these over in the box over here. It doesn't matter where you put the negative 4 and where you put the negative 9. I'll put the negative 4 here and the negative 9 there. All right, so out of the first column, I pull out the greatest common factor, which is 3x. 3x times what is 6x squared? Well, it's 2x. By the way, the first term up here and the first column here, they should both have an x, right? since I need to get x squared. 2x times what is negative 4x? That's going to be negative 2x. And negative 2x times what gives you 6? It's got to be, I'm sorry, that was just a negative 2, not a negative 2x. Negative 2 times negative 3. So this factors to 3x minus 2 times 2x minus 3. Okay, let's contrast that with a shortcut method. You don't have a box, but you do get the negative 4 and the negative 9, so you take the first term, 6x squared, with one of these, negative 4 or negative 9, so let's take the negative 4x, take out the greatest common factor, and now you know that's one of the factors. So you would say, okay, I know one of the factors is 3x minus 2. Remember, I'm trying to get back to, right up here, 6x squared, so 3x times 2x gives you the 6x squared, and the negative 2 times what gives you 6? That's going to be minus 3. Notice I would end up with the same factorization. So that's the correct factorization for 6x squared minus 13x plus 6. Okay, here's one that's just a little bit trickier. Let's do 28 plus 3x minus x squared. Now, usually you don't see the x squared at the end. You see it at the beginning. There's two ways of dealing with this problem. One is to just leave it as it is, but you do want to either have it where the exponents go up in power or down in power. So here, you've got the constant, then the x term, and the x squared. That's all right, but you don't want to have the 28 in the middle. That'll confuse you. Don't put the constant in the middle or the x squared in the middle. So we could go ahead and do this as it is in a box. There's your 28. There's your plus 3x. There's your negative x squared. All right? So this must have been 28, and this must have been negative x squared. And I want to get the sum to be positive 3. So my product, again, has to be the first times the last, 28 times negative 1, or look at it right here, 28 times the coefficient of negative 1. So the product is negative 28, and the sum is positive 3. So we just go along as before. Factors of 28, 1 times 28, 2 times 14, and 4 times 7, and I think that's it. Since the sum is positive, the bigger number is positive, and since the product's negative, the minus sign gives you the opposite sign, and negative 4 and 7, those are the correct combination. So, I need to add up and get 3x, so we know the variable part is x, and now I just have to put the negative 4 in one place and the 7 in the other. So let's say I put the negative 4 here and the 7 here. Doesn't matter. So out of the first column, I pull out the greatest common factor. That's 7. 7 times what will give you 28? 4. 4 times what will give you a negative 4x? Negative x, right? 4 times negative x? And then negative x times what will give you negative x squared? X. So it works. 7 minus x times 4 plus x. So if you want to use the box method, it works just fine. An alternative to doing this way, this problem, is to write it in descending order. So you're going to write negative x squared plus 3x plus 28, and then factor out a negative 1, which means you're going to change signs. So that's an x squared, a minus 3x, and a minus 28. Now, if you do this, in the end, you're going to have, it's going to look a little bit different, but it will be the same answer, a 7 minus x times 4 plus x. So let's continue. Okay. This is actually the easier problem because notice this is where you have a 1 in front of the x squared. So when we do the product sum here, we just know it's going to be x and x. That's the only way to get x squared. So we want the product to be negative 28 and the sum to be negative 3, just like before. We're going to get the same combination, right? It's going to be negative 7 and 4. So I'm going to have negative 7 and plus 4. That does it. Now, contrast that with the answer I wrote up here, which was 7 minus x times 4 plus x. Why are those the same? Well, because if you do the negative 1 times x minus 7, you'll get negative x plus 7, which is the same as 7 minus x. And x plus 4 can be written as 4 plus x. So both are fine. That's it. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.